Our lab conducts measurements all day long on every product you can imagine, both GPUs and CPUs, to power supplies and fans. But let's start by answering some plain questions to get you slowly into today's hot subject. What is a measurement? A measurement is a reading or property of something. For instance, the efficiency of PSU at some specific conditions is a measurement, as is the 12 volt rails voltage level acquired through a multimeter. You need to use an instrument, for example, a multimeter, a thermometer, etc., to get a measurement. So, a measurement consists of two parts, a number and the unit that describes the measurements. For example, we can have 28 degrees Celsius in temperature, and for power, we say, for example, 120 watt. Measurement uncertainty. There is an existing doubt about the result of any measurement. How can I know that the X laboratory provides accurate measurements? How can I be sure that the thermometer I use is trustworthy and provides accurate readings? For any measurement, even those conducted in NASA's labs, there is always a margin of doubt that it is not 100% accurate. This is called uncertainty. How can we express the measurement uncertainty? As I already mentioned, there is always a doubt about any measurement, so we have to consider the uncertainty margin. How large is the doubt I have about the provided measurements? Two numbers can solve this. These two numbers can quantify uncertainty: interval, width of margin, and confidence level, which means how sure we are that the actual value is within the interval. To make it clear, guys, let's provide an example. You have a PSU whose efficiency at 50% load is 90%, plus or minus 0.1% at the 95% confidence level. This can be written 90% plus minus 0.1% at a level of confidence of 95%. This means we are 95% sure the PSU's efficiency is between 89.9% and 90.1%. There are two ways to estimate the uncertainty of a measurement. Type A uses statistics and type B uses any information available. What is the difference between error and uncertainty? These two are entirely different, so I have to provide an explanation. Error refers to the difference between a measured value and the true value. It can be due to mistakes or limitations in measurement, and it can be either systematic, consistent, and predictable, or the worst, random, which is unpredictable. Uncertainty is the level of doubt that we have about a measurement result. In short, uncertainty is the expected range of possible values, while error is the difference between the measured and actual values. We correct errors by calibrating our equipment to meet the original standards and perfecting or inspecting the measurement procedures. That said, if we don't know how significant our errors can be, for example, if we use uncalibrated equipment, we don't know how far it is from the true values readings. Thus, we cannot add the corresponding entry to the uncertainty level. This is why it is a requirement for every lab to have calibrated equipment, otherwise the uncertainty level cannot be calculated correctly. Accuracy versus uncertainty. Accuracy refers to how close a measured value is to the true or accepted value. Uncertainty refers to the amount of error or variability in a measurement, indicating how much the measured value might differ from the actual value. In short, accuracy is about correctness, while uncertainty is about reliability or confidence in the measurement. multiple measurements for more accurate results. There is a saying, measure twice and cut once. This means that when you need to cut something, whatever that is, you typically measure multiple times to be sure before you proceed with the cutting procedure. This is the law among craftsmen. The same applies to most measurements that we take. We run 3 to 5 measurements to see if they are at the same levels and isolate a possible error if something goes wrong during the measurement procedure. So, if we see a test result, a reading that is way higher or lower than the rest, we know we should ignore it. When you get multiple measurements, you use 2 statistical tools, arithmetic mean and standard deviation. The arithmetic mean, often called the average, is calculated by adding all numbers in a data set and dividing by the count of numbers. For example, the arithmetic mean of 2, 4, and 6 is 4. It is usually shown by a symbol with a bar above it. Needless to say, guys, the more readings you get, the more precise the average will be. But at some point, you lose precious time without a significant increase in accuracy. Deviation of results. I know firsthand it's frustrating when we measure the same thing repeatedly and get different results. But we can still use these results to check how widely spread the readings are. This spread can help us calculate the measurement's uncertainty. The larger the spread, the higher the uncertainty, and the opposite, of course, applies. Measuring the distance between the top and bottom values is not enough in most cases. We need the standard deviation, a measure of how spread out or dispersed the values in a data set are. A low SD means the values are close to the mean, aka the average value of all readings, while a high SD means they are more spread out. There is a rule of thumb that states that 68% of all readings will fall between plus and minus 1 standard deviation, covering values with 1 unit above and below the mean. In comparison, 95% will fall within 2 standard deviations, covering values within 2 units above and below the mean. To find the actual standard deviation value, we have to have a vast set of readings, which is impossible in most cases. So, from a decent, moderate number of values, we can only estimate the standard deviation, which is denoted through the symbol S. Needless to say, the more values we have, the more accurate the standard deviation calculation. Distribution patterns. The deviated values can fall closer to the average mean than far from it. This is called a normal or Gaussian distribution. On the other hand, when the readings are evenly spread between the highest and lowest values, we call it a uniform or rectangular distribution. Other distributions also exist, but are beyond the scope of this video. Where do all the problems in measurements derive? Understanding the main factors that can alter the results and divert us from the true readings is essential. Instruments, if they are not calibrated and properly maintained, they will not deliver accurate results. Moreover, if your instrument is calibrated, the corresponding report will have an uncertainty level which you must consider. Operators. If the operator doesn't know how to handle the instrument and measures incorrectly, for example, voltage probes are not installed correctly in PSU's cables, the results will be highly away from the actual readings. Device under test. If you have a PSU with a highly unstable load regulation or operation in general, it will be challenging to get accurate readings. Sample pool. You cannot know if the sample you tested performs similarly to samples from previous or future production batches. The ideal scenario would be to test all samples going out of a production line, which is done to some degree, at least in PSUs, in some highly automated production lines. Still, days of testing are required for thorough results, which is impossible. Environmental conditions play a massive role in every measurement you take. You should keep them as stable as possible. Environmental conditions should be as close as possible for all sample measurements to compare results. What should not be included in the uncertainty measurement? The operator mistakes should not be included because you cannot know when someone will make a mistake or how large this mistake will be, aka how much it will affect the measurements. So, from the moment this is entirely random, you cannot include it in the uncertainty. How to calculate the uncertainty of a measurement? PSU example. First, you must identify all sources of uncertainty in a measurement. Say, you want to measure the PSU's efficiency. You have to take the following into account besides the environmental conditions. The equipment that you will use, AC source, DC loads, power analyzer, test fixture, cabling. Then, you have to calculate the uncertainty of each of the above, which will actually affect the efficiency measurement. The individual uncertainty levels combined will provide the total uncertainty. The main steps to evaluating the overall uncertainty of a measurement are: identify all sources of uncertainty, determine the factors contributing to uncertainty, like instrument precision, environmental conditions, or measurement methods. Estimate individual uncertainties, assign uncertainty value to each source, often based on instrument specifications and calibration. Determine the type of uncertainty, classify each uncertainty as systematic, consistent, or random variable. Calculate the combined uncertainty for addition or subtraction at the absolute uncertainties. For multiplication or division, add the relative percentage uncertainties. Use error propagation formulas. Apply the correct formulas when combining uncertainties for complex calculations, especially for functions or multiple measurements. Account for correlated uncertainties. If any measurements are related, adjust for the correlation when combining uncertainties. Express the overall uncertainty. Determine the total uncertainty, often as a range. Report the result. Present the measurement with its associated uncertainty, indicating the precision of the result. Standard uncertainty definition. Standard uncertainty is the estimated uncertainty of a measurement expressed as a standard deviation. It represents the range within which the true value of a measurement is likely to lie, with a certain level of confidence, typically 68% of a normal distribution. The symbol for standard uncertainty is usually represented by a U and X in parentheses, where X is the measured quantity. It indicates the uncertainty associated with that particular measurement. Standard uncertainty calculation example. Type A. Say we have a number of repeated readings from a sample, for example, a PSU's efficiency at 100% load conducted on different days by different operators. We calculate the mean value and the standard deviation, S. From this, we can get the estimated standard uncertainty, U, of the mean with this formula, where N is the number of measurements. Standard uncertainty calculation example, type B. If we don't have enough information, we can still get an estimate of the upper and lower limits of the uncertainty. We will have to assume the distribution of the values. For example, the standard uncertainty for the uniform distribution is in this equation, where A and B are the limits of the rectangular distribution, the minimum and maximum values. We can also use this type where A is the semi-range or half width between the upper and lower limits. Uniform distribution patterns are the most common, but you should keep in mind that uncertainties imported from calibration certificates are typically normally distributed, meaning spread factor K equals to 2. Can type A and type B uncertainty levels be combined? Yes, they can, and in some cases you actually have to combine them to get the combined standard uncertainty. Combined standard uncertainty refers to the overall uncertainty in a measurement that arises from multiple independent sources. It is the result of combining individual uncertainties from different sources, such as instrument errors, calibration errors, all measurement techniques. Equation 4, where U1, U2, and U n are the standard uncertainties for each source. This is the simplest scenario and applies when the uncertainty levels are independent of each other. If the uncertainty levels are correlated, a more complex approach is needed, which is beyond the scope of this video. The coverage factor, K, is a multiplier used to calculate an interval around a measurement result within which the true value is expected to lie with a certain confidence level. It is typically used in conjunction with a standard uncertainty to define a confidence interval. For example, K equals 1 corresponds to 68% confidence level of a normal distribution. K equals 2 corresponds to 95% confidence level, most commonly used, and K equals 3 corresponds to a 99% confidence level. The result is often expressed as measurement plus minus K by UC, where UC is the standard uncertainty. This is a very, very complex topic. We only scratch the surface of it through this video, but I want you to get one thing out of this whole video, that whenever you see results, you have to ask about the uncertainty. How sure the operator, the guy, the whoever takes these results, whoever runs these tests and gets these results, how sure he is, she is about the results. How close he believes that these results are to the true ones, to the actual ones. This is very vague, yeah, I know, because it is impossible to have an idea of the two results if you don't have a reference, but through the uncertainty calculations, you can know how far you are, and you can also provide the doubt, the uncertainty level. If you have any questions, feel free to leave them in the comment section. Please subscribe to our channel, guys. We are doing whatever is possible to educate you on some matters that are not so popular or are very complex. And you can check everything we do also on hwbusters.com. That's all. Bye-bye.